Shalaka Foy, the British Virgin Islands! Four beautifully confident women from all over the world take the stage to compete for the title of Miss Universe. Hosted by Maria Menounos, Olivia Culpo, and Jeannie Mai, with commentary by Catriona Gray and me, Zuri Hall. Plus, two performances by Grammy winner John Legend. Now, please welcome the host of Heel Squad, Maria Menounos, Miss Universe 2012, Olivia Culpo, and Emmy Award winner, Jeannie Mai.
Now tell me, is that a way to start the night? Woo! Can we give it up for all the delegates? They look fire in their Clarice Designs opening number dresses.
Welcome to the 72nd Miss Universe! There is so much excitement here, not just in this building, but in the entire country.
I know they are so delighted to have us, and we ladies, because it's so exciting to be doing this here. And also with my ladies. Yes, give it up for the girls in the house.
It feels perfect for three women, three friends, to host this show together.
There is a lot of girl power on this stage right now.
Yes, and it's not just us. 84 women are here to compete for one crown.
They have all earned the right to represent their home country, and tonight they are looking to win on the global stage.
The whole world is watching, including the fans at home and the ones who have traveled here to support them.
I want to hear you all right now!
Former Miss Universe, what is it like to compete on this stage?
I mean, it was a dream of mine ever since I watched you compete in Miss Teen USA. I wanted to be Maria Menounos, and now I'm working with you.
Oh, I love you. And you know, I'm sure that you have inspired so many of these women here tonight.
No doubt about that. The Miss Universe crown comes with an incredible responsibility and an opportunity to use a global platform to share her voice.
These delegates are all strong leaders and determined competitors who exemplify what Miss Universe is all about. They are world-class athletes, activists, grad students, businesswomen, lawyers.
And we are rooting for every single one of them.
Yes, we are. To help bring us inside, all night long, we've got our two correspondents, Access Hollywood, Zuri Hall, and Miss Universe 2018, Katriana Gray. What are your thoughts on the competition tonight, Zuri?
Well, first of all, Maria, y'all look fabulous. The women are ready, and so are the fans.
Yes, so much that you'll see on the show is the work of Salvadorians bringing their pride and love to represent their country in the best way that you know how.
Yes.
And if you don't know about El Salvador, the country, if you're a visitor or watching online, we have you covered. There is city life,
yes.
Surfing,
yes.
And Zuri, over 100 volcanoes.
That's a whole lot of volcanoes, girl.
Yes, it is. It is a unique and wonderful place, and these women have been enjoying the country to the fullest since the minute that they arrived.
Comenzó el Miss Universe. Ya está en El Salvador. From the moment I have landed in El Salvador, it feels like home. Fans are everywhere.
This is a perfect opportunity where we have a few moments to relax, a little bit of downtime.
And then we get some amazing gifts from Miss Universe. And look what I got. It's so pretty.
These look so exciting.
Good.
How much skincare can be in this?
There's no such thing as too much skincare.
We're gonna do our new routine tonight.
See you.
Bye.
It really is so exciting to be here, not just for the competitors, but for all of us. This is a historic show for so many reasons. It's the first Miss Universe competition in Central America since Panama hosted in 2003, and it's the first in El Salvador since 1975, which was also held right here in this arena.
That's so cool.
And it looked a lot different back then. This place has had a complete makeover and upgrade, and we're just so happy to be back.
Yeah. All right, now let's break down the rules for you, okay? Don't worry, we're not gonna quiz you guys.
The competition began earlier this week when all 84 women faced off in a preliminary swim, evening gown, and interview round.
From there, 19 women were chosen to move on to the semifinals, and one more was picked by you, the fans, with a global online vote through the Miss Universe app.
That's right, and then tonight, the 20 semifinalists will compete in their swimsuits before the field is cut in half for the evening gown round.
Then just 5 women will move on to face a question directly from tonight's selection committee, who will then pick 3 women to head to the final round and face one more question. Those answers plus a final look will help determine who wins the coveted Mawad crown.
We are just moments away from finding out which women have made it into the semifinals. But first, let's meet the members of our selection committee, who will be tasked
with choosing the 72nd Miss Universe. Every year, the Miss Universe organization empowers a panel of leaders, entrepreneurs, and entertainers who are tasked with the awesome responsibility of crowning our new winner. Believe me, they will truly be changing someone's life this year. And the selection committee members are trailblazing model and designer Halima Aden,
singer-songwriter and one of the biggest stars in Latin music, Mario Bautista!
And the host of Telemundo's La Mesa Caliente, Giselle Blondet! Hey, girl!
Trinidadian politician and Miss Universe 1977, Janelle Chamision.
She is a model, singer, and Miss Universe Paraguay 2021, Nadia Ferreira!
TikTok superstar and member of Forbes 30 Under 30. Give it up for Albany Gregg.
Emmy Award-winning style expert from Queer Eye and RuPaul's Drag Race, Grace Carson Presley.
Hi, Carson. The first military woman to become White House physician and first Filipino-American Navy Admiral, Dr. Connie Mariano.
Model, TV host, and Miss Universe 2016, Iris Mittenaire.
Head of Marketing and Merchandising at Roku, Sweta Patel.
And the CEO of EAG Sports Management, a former Miss Oregon USA, Denise White.
That is our committee, man. Thank you all for joining us. We don't just have an illustrious selection committee. We've got 12-time Grammy winner John Legend in the house. He's performing not once, but twice for us later tonight. And when we come back, we'll reveal which of our 84 delegates will head to the semifinals. This right now is the 72nd Miss Universe competition live on the Roku channel.
You can reach millions of streamers on the biggest screen in the home. Look no further than Roku Ads Manager. Our easy-to-use platform lets you create streaming ads that are proven to perform, and you can buy once to deliver everywhere, not just on Roku devices. So whether you're looking to reach a big audience or a small one, you can start your TV streaming campaign today with Roku Ads Manager. Learn more and sign up today.
Updating your home can make a massive difference.
This is going to be awesome. And if it's not, go after her.
Oh my God!
With changing these homes, we can change families.
From hot beignets in the French Quarter to ice-cold sake in the wetlands, we're cooking up a new season of delicious Louisiana dishes. Welcome back to Emerald Cooks.
This is the movie that we're going to make.
We're improvising the action scenes.
Nice to beef you.
They're literally trying to murder us.
Only one man can help you.
Go.
Kevin Hart!
Well, how do you like your tea?
This competition is about understanding the fundamentals and traditions in sushi and Japanese cuisine.
I'm ready.
Yes! This could be anyone's game.
For everyone out there, follow your dreams!
Now you can binge your favorite Martha Stewart lifestyle shows free on the Roku channel. Learn classic cooking techniques and live your very best life. What can I say? I'm a bit of a multitasker.
We call ourselves Cowboy Sky Watchers. What we're looking into is extraterrestrial activity.
What was that? What was that?
We're seeing two white lights.
Taking any breaks. Of course, guys, welcome to the first of our Roku Channel bonus segments live from San Salvador at Miss Universe 2023.
That is right. We are live streaming with you throughout the night exclusively on the Roku Channel and taking you behind the scenes of Miss Universe. We're interviewing some fantastic guests representing the competition.
That plus previews of brand new free original movies and shows you can only find streaming on the Roku channel.
That's right. And of course, my girl Kat right here was Miss Universe in 2018, baby. So she's got all the insider info.
Yes,
she knows exactly how these delegates are feeling at key moments in the competition.
Yeah, Zuri, watching the show, being here brings back all the feels, so many great memories for me. And tonight we're making some new ones. And guys, I am so excited to see John Legend perform later in the show.
Yes, my fellow Ohioan, we are counting down. Now, for all of you watching at home, this is your chance to be a part of this universe, okay? We want you to join this conversation. Hit us up on our Instagram stories at the Roku channel with your questions and your comments.
Yes, please do. And you might just get a shout out live in the next Roku channel bonus segment. Now, we have been absolutely loving our time in San Salvador this week, guys.
So beautiful. I mean, so we learned a lot about our host country. Like, for example, El Salvador's nickname is the land of volcanoes. Over 100 volcanoes here.
I mean, I'm only comfortable with, like, lava in the form of a wok, so.
Well, no need to worry. They're mostly dormant. All right, we'll see you back here for more bonus segments. Now let's go back to the main stage.
Welcome back to Miss Universe, live in El Salvador. It is incredible to see how much work these women have put into this competition.
It really is a great test of perseverance, poise, and desire. It's game time from the minute you find out you're competing for the crown, honestly, I remember.
Absolutely. Now, 84 women made it to the stage tonight, and now it's time to narrow it down to just 20 semifinalists. If you've seen the Marby movie, this is pretty much selecting the next Supreme Court.
Yeah.
Okay, let's meet the semifinalists. The first woman to advance is... Nicaragua!
Hola, soy Shaney's Palacios. Miss Nicaragua 2023, soy licenciada en comunicación, me fascina el mundo de la producción audiovisual y es por esa razón también que inicié con mi proyecto Entiende tu mente, que brinda las herramientas necesarias para la excelente gestión de las emociones. Nace a través de mis episodios ansiosos que iniciaron cuando tenía la edad de 18 años, llegué a lastimar mis brazos, a arrancarme cabello, no tenía las herramientas necesarias hasta que fui en busca de un especialista. Por eso yo quiero darles a todas las personas, sin importar sexo o edad, estas herramientas para que no sufran lo que yo sufrí.
Up next is... Spain!
My name is Atenea Pérez Unzué and I am Miss Universe Spain 2023. Ser la primera mujer negra en ser coronada como Miss Universo España ha sido un gran reto para mí. Creo que la diversidad es el futuro y en la actualidad soy ejemplo de ello. En la actualidad estoy colaborando con aldeas infantiles, con las madres inmigrantes y también hogares monoparentales, porque yo he sido criada por una madre soltera, inmigrante y negra, y sé que mi historia puede llegar a ayudar a inspirar a otras personas. La diversidad está aquí. Y la diversidad es ahora, es hoy.
Miss Universe Puerto Rico.
I am a counseling psychology graduate student. I worked as a crisis handler in the National Suicide Hotline in Puerto Rico. I also have my nonprofit organization called Comencemos a Sanar, which is Let's Begin to Heal, and it impacts the mental health of Puerto Ricans. Ever since a young age, I've been struggling with my own mental health. I struggled with suicidal thoughts when I was young. After looking for professional help, empowering myself with different tools and practices, and becoming the woman that I am today, without mental health, there is no help.
The next woman still in the running is Namibia!
Truly shocked.
My name is Jamila Cuiras, Miss Universe Namibia 2023. I grew up in a very abusive household. There were some days I had to sleep in a very old car that was parked in our yard, and I'd put some headphones in my ears and I'd listen to music and I'd look at the moonlight. Also now I'm a disc jockey, I'm a DJ. Music sort of healed me throughout that process. I went through so much, but I'm sitting here right now. I'm trying to be the beacon of hope for you, and I want you to believe in yourself. As much as it may seem like they are dark days, remember that the moon only shines while it's dark.
The fifth semi-finalist is... Who is it? Who is it? Venezuela!
My name is Diana Carolina Silva. I'm proud to represent my beautiful country, Venezuela. I decided to show the world how powerful Venezuelans are. I consider myself a woman quite sensitive to different social issues. When I was 10 years old, I was watching the Miss Universe, and in that moment, I told my mom I wanna to be over there. And also, I have a really passion for give girls tools to improve in their life. I believe if you give them the right tools, they can improve, they can make the dreams come true when you work hard.
Heading to the top 20 is India!
Namaste everyone. This is me, Shweta Sharda, Miss Universe India. I'm a professional dancer and a choreographer, and it's been 5 years that I have been choreographing in Mumbai's Kuchli film industry, and I have got the privilege to choreograph almost every big Bollywood star of my nation. I was 12 years old when I started dancing. Dancing is like breathing for me. It makes me feel happy because through dancing, I can connect with everyone on the profound level of emotions. It was my sheer determination and my passion that really gave me the boost and the confidence to represent myself as a strong woman who I am.
And the next delegate who still has a shot at the crown is... Thailand!
Hello, Universe. I am Antonia Forsild, Miss Universe Thailand. I graduated with a major of public relations and advertising. I also have my own charity project called Little Steps, which I founded 10 years ago to give back to communities in need in rural areas of Thailand. I know that I have the platform to be the voice for the people who feel like their voices are unheard. And I've also felt many times that my voice was unheard, and I know that that hurt me. I don't want to say that I'm advocating for women's empowerment, because that's what we should be doing every day, that we teach people, and that should become our norm.
Congratulations to the first group of semifinalists. Now 13 more women will be joining them, so stay right there. We'll be right back.
Updating your home can make a massive difference.
This is going to be awesome. And if it's not, go after her.
Oh my God!
With changing these homes, we can change families.
From hot beignets in the French Quarter to ice-cold sake in the wetlands, we're cooking up a new season of delicious Louisiana dishes. Welcome back to Emerald Cooks.
This is the movie that we're gonna make.
We're improvising the action scenes.
Nice to beef you.
They're literally trying to murder us.
Only one man can help you.
Go.
It's Kevin Hart.
Well, how do you like your tea?
This competition is about understanding the fundamentals and traditions in sushi and Japanese cuisine.
I'm ready.
This could be anyone's game.
For everyone out there, follow your dream!
Now you can binge your favorite Martha Stewart lifestyle shows free on the Roku channel. Learn classic cooking techniques and live your very best life. What can I say? I'm a bit of a multitasker.
We call ourselves Cowboy Sky Watchers. What we're looking into is extraterrestrial activity.
What was that? What was
that?
We're seeing two white lights.
When we were little, we loved playing with Lincoln Logs.
Now we play with these logs. We aren't the only log home builders with the Lincoln Logs stamp of approval.
Back in business!
We play with big machines, hardcore tools, and we are Lincoln Log Masters.
The Marriage Pact, an agreement between two people that if they're still single by a certain due date, they'll marry each other.
Holy f***.
I suck at relationships. It's the truth.
Welcome back to our bonus segment. Right now, we have got a look at a brand new Roku comedy series set during the busy holidays at a shopping mall. Crowd going wild back here.
Yeah, you guys are going to love this show. It's got everything you possibly want. Love, laughter, and of course, shopping.
All my favorite things. It's called The Holiday Shift. Check it out.
This is a love story.
She's the one that got away.
Tess!
Yay!
The love of his life, the one.
I need to hear what you've been up to for the last 4 years. Do you want to grab a coffee?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, he punched her boob.
You have to tell her how you feel.
What is happening over here? How did you not know she had a boyfriend?
She moved to California. How was I supposed to know?
The internet, TikTok, Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter if you're weird, Facebook if you're old.
That looks like so much fun. I'm adding it to my watch list. Yes, finally, a workplace comedy set at the mall, one of my favorite places. Kat, did you ever have a job at the mall?
I mean, can I count shopping as a job?
Only for you, because okay. I love you. I'll yes, that it. Counts, okay? I used to repair watches.
Ooh, at the mall. Okay. Random. I love that. So this show is like a combo of Superstore and Love Actually with great guest stars like Sarah Levy from Schitt's Creek. I love that. Stand-up comedian John Doerr and the biggest star of all, of course, Santa Claus.
My guy, The Holiday Shift is streaming right now for free on Roku. If you stay tuned, you can watch the first two episodes on this channel right after Miss Universe. We will be back later with that bonus segment. Right now, let's go back to the main stage for more of the top 20. You ready?
I think I'm ready. I mean, the crowd here is ready.
The
Are you guys ready?
The crowd is clearly ready. Take it
Let's
away,
go.
Ladies.
Welcome back to the 72nd Miss Universe competition live in El Salvador.
We've already revealed the first seven of our semifinalists, and now it's time to meet our second group.
Woo, I'm so excited. All right. The next delegate to advance to the semifinals is... Chile!
Hi, I'm Celeste Vial, Miss Universe Chile 2023. Well, my parents actually met when my mom was crowned Miss Chile in 1992. My dad was the man who gave her the flowers when she won, and that was the first time he actually saw her. And 7 years later, he asked her out. So I think me being here today is kind of just a crazy life experience that my parents actually met in this pageant. My siblings, I actually have three foster siblings that we adopted, and that is where my social project comes from. I want to raise awareness for foster children and increase adoptions around the world because I think it is so important that as families we open our hearts and our homes to these loving kids.
Joining her in the next round is... Jamaica!
Hi everyone, it's Jordan Levy, Miss Universe Jamaica.
I'm a medical doctor. My goal in life is really to make others feel better about themselves. I once was a young girl that struggled with self-confidence and bullying. And it takes working on yourself, doing those positive affirmations in the mirror to really make you out to be the most incredible version of who you are. I'm the creator of the Be Beautiful campaign, emphasis on the being you, and it's a female empowerment movement in Jamaica that I want to expand to the universe through education and self-awareness.
Also moving to the next round is... USA!
I'm Noelia Voigt, and I am Miss Universe USA. I was the first Venezuelan-American woman to win the title. I represent all of the second-generation children of immigrants in the United States of America. I am a fervent advocate for immigration rights and reform, dating violence awareness and prevention, and anti-bullying. I authored an anti-bullying children's book in honor of a 9-year-old girl from Birmingham, Alabama, who sadly took her own life after being bullied in school, hoping to spread awareness about the dangers of bullying. Hopefully, we can stop that from ever happening again. To be Miss USA is to be a queen of the people, to be a symbol of unity, diversity, and inclusivity.
The 11th delegate advancing is... Nepal!
Jane Deepika Garrett, Miss Universe Nepal 2023. On the surface, I'm representing women of different bodies, shapes, and sizes, but I'm representing strength, I'm representing resilience, I'm representing how to change your whole life. Growing up, I dealt with a lot of mental health and hormonal health issues. Even a year ago, I was in the hospital for attempting to end my life. Ever since then, I decided to transform my life. My purpose is to inspire millions of women around the world who feel like they're not enough, who feel like their body isn't beautiful, who feel like they're not worthy. My goal is to change that.
Heading to the top 20, it is Peru!
Hola, soy Camila Escriven, Miss Peru Universo. That's always been a lifelong dream to represent my country, Peru, in the Olympics, but because of medical problems, that dream didn't come into fruition. At a very young age, I actually was discovered 3 AVMs called arteriovenous malformation, and I had it in 3 spots in my brain. No matter what dream you have in life, you can accomplish it. I looked at death in the face, and I am now here on this earth, healthy, with my nonprofit organization, AMA, that I'm so proud to represent, where we put sports fields and parks all over the poorest places of Peru.
The next woman to move ahead is... Cameroon!
Hello everyone, I'm Issia Princess. I'm the Miss Universe Cameroon 2023. One cause that is really, like, really takes into my heart is about breast cancer. The reason is because I have my close friend, let me say my best friend, when I was in from 2, we're 12 years old, and she had breast cancer. We were really sad, but when I was growing up, I created an association, the Cameroon Women Action, which is helping financially, psychologically, and physically women affected by breast cancer. I told myself that if I have to choose, a project is something that I really carry in my heart. I just decided to help, and I love doing it.
And the 14th delegate still in the running is... Colombia!
Yeah. Soy Camila Bella, Miss Universo Colombia 2023. Cuando me topé con niñas, madres, embarazadas, fue un impacto bastante grande. Y al convertirme en madre, dije, ya es el momento de mostrar esta realidad y es el momento de que Colombia y el universo entero se entere de que hay niñas que han sido abusadas en sus familias, que tienen embarazos no deseados, hijos no deseados. Vamos a empezar a trabajar por ellas, vamos a empezar a mostrar y a prevenir el embarazo infantil y adolescente. Realmente, si nos enfocamos en prevenir el embarazo infantil y adolescente, pues ya estamos no solamente ayudando a estas niñas, sino ayudando a sus hijos. Mi hija llegó a transformar mi vida y gracias a ella hoy estoy aquí.
Seven more delegates have moved forward. Congratulations, ladies.
Yup, when we come back, we'll find out which six of our remaining delegates will be heading to the semifinals. It's so much tension in the
room.
It's
the 72nd Miss Universe live from El Salvador.
Today, we are in Parque Cuscatlán for the Traditions from My Land Festival. This is a sensory experience for young children in public schools and orphanages, as well as their families, of course.
On behalf of this government and the Office of the First Lady, we give you the warmest welcome to this tradition of my land festival.
They're very excited. They're very energetic to receive us.
Is the best way to channel their energy into positivity.
I'm learning about the cultural heritage that the people have around in El Salvador.
I'm so thankful for embracing us and just infusing us with their rich culture.
Updating your home can make a massive difference.
This is going to be awesome. And if it's not, go after her.
Oh my God!
With changing these homes, we can change families.
Hot beignets in the French Quarter to ice-cold sake in the wetlands. We're cooking up a new season of delicious Louisiana dishes. Welcome back to Emerald Cooks.
This is the movie that we're going to make.
We're improvising the action scenes.
Nice to beef you.
They're literally trying to murder us.
Only one man can help you.
Go.
It's Kevin Hart.
Well, how do you like your tea?
This competition is about understanding the fundamentals and traditions in sushi and Japanese cuisine.
I'm ready.
Yes! This could be anyone's game.
For everyone out there, follow your dreams!
Now you can binge your favorite Martha Stewart lifestyle shows free on the Roku channel. Learn classic cooking techniques and live your very best life. What can I say? I'm a bit of a multitasker.
Call ourselves Cowboy Sky Watchers. What we're looking into is extraterrestrial activity.
What the hell was that? We're seeing two white lights.
When we were little, we loved playing with Lincoln Logs.
Now we play with these logs. We are the only log home builders with the Lincoln Log stamp of approval.
Back in business!
We play with big machines, hardcore tools, and we are Lincoln Log Masters.
The Marriage Pact, an agreement between two people that if they're still single by a certain due date, they'll marry each other.
Holy f***.
I suck at relationships. It's the truth.
Channel bonus segments, and I'm joined, of course, by a very familiar face to those of you who love and follow Miss Universe. She's an advocate for women around the world, and of course, the president of Miss Universe, Paula Sugar.
Hi.
Hi, welcome. Thank you so much for coming and joining me here at the booth. And it's also such a special time that I can spend with you.
It is. I'm glad we have to have this moment together.
I know, and this is such a poignant moment, guys, because on Thursday night on the costume show, you actually announced that you're redirecting and moving on after 25 years of really being the spearhead, the leader, and the president of the Miss Universe organization. What moment are you most proud of when you look back on those 25 years?
Honestly, there's not one moment, and I'm going to be working on writing a book, so I can talk about all the great adventures of the last 25 years. Yes.
There must be so many. And can you give us a little hint, though? We're dying to know. I'm sure our viewers as well. What are you planning on pursuing next, and how can we support you?
Well, aside from the book, as you know, my husband is in the cannabis business, as Spot Farms, so I'm going to be joining him and working on the company and really focusing on philanthropy and really helping veterans to that are dealing with PTSD and how cannabis can help them, because that my father's legacy as an admiral and a veteran, so I really want to focus on that and work with my husband for once.
I love that. The values are still aligned there, even though it's a different avenue. My regards to Carl as well, if you're watching. Hi, Carl.
He and the cats say hi.
And the cats. I miss the cats. Well, thank you so much for joining us, Paula. This is an unforgettable show.
Thank you. Love you.
The next round,
which means for 64 women, this is going to be the end of their competition.
Before we get to the selection, remember, every delegate who made it to this stage should be proud to be representing their country, and it's an incredible accomplishment just to be here.
Yep. So let's give them one more big round of applause. Ladies, you ready for this?
Yes, I'm guarding this.
It is time for us to meet the last group of semifinalists. Moving to the next round is Pakistan!
Assalamu alaikum and hello everyone. This is Erica Robin. I'm 25 years old and I'm the first ever Miss Universe Pakistan. This is the perfect opportunity for me to step in to show the brighter side of my country. Also, to break all the stereotypes that people have for a Pakistani woman. My advocacy can help other women. I would love to do that because my advocacy is to help them exercise and participate in the arts and media field and take over, because women, we are not less than anyone. And anyone that tells you that you can do this, you can do that, prove them wrong. And that's why I'm here. And I do believe that stories do make difference. And it's high time now to show the world.
Still in the running for the Miss Universe crown is Australia!
Hi, my name is Mariah Wilson, Miss Universe Australia 2023. I actually grew up as a downhill ski racer and a track athlete as well. So I did right from the start of my childhood up until I was 19. That took a lot of independence. From a young age, I would travel overseas. I went back to my secondary school that I graduated from and started coaching as an athletics cross country and snow sports coach. I was really able to be a role model and be a guide. Sport can teach you confidence, it teaches you discipline, it teaches you how to work hard, how to show up. You learn how to be really resilient from sport, and I think they're really special skills to have as a person.
Joining our top 20!
Michelle Marquez, the Miss Universe Philippines. I am an award-winning actress. I'm a certified adrenaline junkie. I love creative direction. I have joined the Air Force Reserves. I actually graduated from psychology at De La Salle University and as well as entrepreneurship course from Harvard University online. And more notably, I've been a lifelong advocate for individuals on the autism spectrum. I started my own foundation for my autism advocacy. I want to be the voice of millions of individuals on the autism spectrum that deserve to be celebrated, empowered, and given the right opportunities to live a fulfilled and purposeful life.
Only three spots left. You ready? The next delegate moving ahead is Portugal!
Hi everyone, I'm Marina Machete, Miss Universe Portugal.
As a young child, I did feel lost. Looking back and seeing how I was fighting for my existence to be comprehended by people, it was very hard to be a victim of this bullying. Since I've been a teenager that I've been involved in social projects in Portugal, it really helped to bring forward the groundbreaking law of 2016 that really changes the way people treat and see trans people in my country. This law opened up so many new opportunities for people to get medical help and get the support they need from the ones they love. At the time, I did feel like I had to fight for my rights, but now looking back, I see that I was fighting for so many other people, and all this time later, it finally paid off.
Taking the next step towards the title is... South Africa!
Hi, my name is Bryony Govender, and I'm Miss Universe South Africa 2023. The last time a person who looked like me represented South Africa at Miss Universe was in 1997. I'm standing here not only for myself, but for each and every South African and every person in the world who comes from a minority community. I am the first in my family to go to university and to get a university degree. I decided to go and study law because I want to empower women by educating them on their legal rights. I also want to show the world that we as women are dynamic. She can become whatever she is and whatever she wants to.
In the semifinals goes to El Salvador!
I'm Isabella Garcia Manso, Miss Universe El Salvador 2023. I've always had that dream since I'm a kid to build my own ecological hotel. I have this very important connection to nature, and also with surfing, I want to do an impact. Surf is a big part of my life. Every time I'm in the ocean, I am just in my element. That's what I want to send that message. I want to advocate and I want to tell young Salvadorians that surf is a lifestyle, and it's made me the brave and strong and dedicated and disciplined woman I am today.
Congratulations to our last group of semi-finalists and to all the remarkable women who will not be moving on. Hold your heads high. You should be incredibly proud of making it this far.
We have 20 delegates left, but only one will get to wear the Mawat Force for Good crown this year, and they have a lot to live up to.
Absolutely. Let's take a look at last year's winner, the 71st Miss Universe, Ra'Arbani Gabriel. USA!
It was the most euphoric feeling ever. All the hard work, all my friends and family backing me up, cheering me on, and I will hold that for the rest of my life.
I cannot believe it.
My main mission was to spread awareness about sustainable fashion.
Upcycled denim look.
I was able to talk to young designers and really spread my message and share my journey as Miss Universe. That was such a full circle moment for me. The Miss Universe crown to me represents a woman's growth and transformation. I was a totally different woman, and I know that it does that for every woman that goes through this journey as well.
That was exceptionally beautiful. Give it up for our reigning Miss Universe, Miss Ra'Arbani Gabriel!
People. Ra'Arbani, how has becoming Miss Universe changed your life?
Y'all, my life has changed forever.
I bet.
And it happened so fast. I mean, I've been blessed to travel to so many countries, meet so many inspiring people, and let me tell you, the fans are the most incredible fans in the world. That's awesome. But more importantly, Miss Universe gave me the platform to amplify my voice for sustainable fashion, and even after Miss Universe, I'll continue on. I'm actually dropping a new collection of fully recycled materials and designs to continue this mission on my website at Arbony NOLA, because this is what I stand for, and this is who I am, and I'm just blessed to share this with the world.
Amazing. And I know you want to thank someone very special.
Yes, my reign would not be complete without thanking Miss Anne. Thank you so much for these opportunities.
Thank you, Arbony. The swimsuit competition is coming up next, and we've still got two performances from John Legend on the way, all in the 72nd Miss Universe.
Updating your home can make a massive difference.
This is going to be awesome.
And if it's not, go after her.
Oh my God!
With changing these homes, we can change families.
We're seeing two white lights.
When we were little, we loved playing with Lincoln Logs.
Now we play with these logs. We aren't the only log home builders with the Lincoln Logs stamp of approval.
Back in business!
We play with big machines, hardcore tools, and we are Lincoln Log Masters.
The Marriage Pact, an agreement between two people that if they're still single by a certain due date, they'll marry each other.
Holy f***.
I suck at relationships. It's the truth.
It is time for another bonus segment. Roku is your home for free TV, Roku Originals, and premium entertainment.
And there is always a fresh selection of hit TV shows and movies. Here's just a taste of what's waiting for you on the Roku channel.
How much are movies now? Like $200?
Nope, they're free.
Let the showdown begin!
I'm about to spill the tea.
Here we go.
It's 24 of us, only one comes out.
Boom shakalaka.
Find Jason Bourne.
Unfreaking believable. It's crazy. What did you just say?
Sign me up. As we just saw, Roku has the biggest stars and franchises available to stream.
Yes, they do. Like my girl Katniss, Jennifer Lawrence in the Hunger Games films. Guys, I'm definitely going to do a marathon of all that before I go and see the new movie.
It's sounding like a girl's night in the making.
Let's plan
just
it.
So many great movies to choose from, plus 24/7 live news and popular kids programming, all totally free. You can pick from thousands of on-demand entertainment options with no subscriptions, no purchases, and no rentals necessary.
I mean, no reasons to say no.
That part.
And next month in December, you can look forward to more hits like Mamma Mia, with, of course, the legend herself, Meryl Streep. It's the perfect mother-daughter movie, and I don't know about you guys, but I burst out laughing every time Pierce Brosnan breaks into his first song.
So good. All right, y'all, we will be back in just a bit with another bonus segment. Let's get back to the main stage. It is time for the swimsuit competition.
Let's go, ladies.
Here at Jojo Brigais, we aspire to create world-class shoes. For the 72nd Miss Universe, we specifically crafted this design that signifies joining of the universe. every pair are crafted to be strong enough to hold the power of every woman's walk. We want women to see Jojo Bregay's shoes as a loyal companion, someone they can rely on during their most memorable challenges in life. Jojo Bregay's walk win.
We're finally at Miss Universe. Yeah. There's no time to be nervous anymore.
Truly feeling everything, the excitement, the adrenaline, the nerves, the fear, the sadness.
Now it feels like the real Miss Universe.
It's just been years
and years. 1 minute. 1 minute, I need all ladies in your chair.
Stephanie is a strong woman.
She says exactly how it is. She says, no, you don't do that, you do this.
Today, I felt the vibe of the room and they were playful. I got them moving around and then I said, look, we need you to trust us. Our job is to make every single one of you look your best.
Really running on fumes and adrenaline at this point.
We haven't, like, slept too much.
My feet are so sore.
They are dead.
And I really want to do well. I have to do well.
Welcome back to the 72nd Miss Universe competition. I am backstage with these beautiful women. It is the swimsuit competition. They are getting ready in their Ruben Singer swimwear. How do you guys feel? You look amazing. I remember this like it was yesterday. The nerves are off the charts. You have to race off stage, get changed into your swimsuit as fast as possible, and then hit the runway like you've been ready for this moment your entire life. But you guys look very ready. Jeannie and Maria, what do you think?
They do look ready,
definitely.
Olivia. Okay, our 20 semifinalists are about to take on the swimsuit competition. The selection committee will be choosing 10 of them to move forward to the evening gown round.
Ooh, that's right. Only half of these women will have a chance to impress in the dress. Yes.
And the swimsuit competition begins now.
Hey, that's my song. Hey, let's give it up for the semifinalists.
My guess is that after tonight, Shayna's is going to have some super fans of her own.
Work it, Nicaragua.
Spain! Spain has lived in Italy, the United States, Germany, Morocco, Greece, and Spain. And her mom is from Equatorial Guinea. So while she's here representing Spain, Atenea considers herself a citizen of the world. Let's go, Spain.
Puerto Rico!
She asked her a homecoming parade after she won her national title. Locals say the last time the town celebrated someone so passionately was when Patias Angela Lind competed in the 1984 Olympics. Looks like we'll have something to celebrate now.
Woo! Namibia!
Walking the Miss Universe stage in her JoJo Bregay's heels is literally a dream come true for Namibia. She says tonight is the culmination of years of hard work, perseverance, and dedication to both herself and her goals.
She's had an entire year to prepare. To put that in context, some of this year's delegates had mere weeks to prep before traveling to El Salvador. Well, let's see if our preparation pays off tonight and how she's working that stage. It looks like it is.
As a dancer and choreographer, India is absolutely at home on stage. It's worth noting that this year's delegates had 10 different swimwear styles to choose from, including two burkinis.
Thailand!
Now, this is not Thailand's first international competition. In fact, she represented her country at another pageant in 2019. And walked away with a crown. Antonia is hoping history repeats, and she's named 72nd Miss Universe tonight. Chile! Chile became a certified health coach during the pandemic and says that training has served her well as she prepared for Miss Universe. Fun fact, she's actually related to Saint Teresa of the Andes, the only saint in Chilean history. says she was not the fan favorite at her national competition, but Jordan didn't let that slow her down. Given that she's now made the top 20, I'd say fan favorite or not, she is a force to be reckoned with.
USA!
USA is a girl with goals. In addition to obviously wanting the 72nd Miss Universe crown, Noelia hopes to eventually own an interior design firm, star in her own TV show, and publish an international magazine.
Nepal is an animal lover and has something of a miniature zoo back home. Jane has ducks, hamsters, dogs, cats, fish, turtles, and rabbits. Woo! So if she wins Miss Universe, she's probably going to need about thinking about hiring a zookeeper. Work it, girl!
And that room is going to be celebrating tonight as both of them advanced into the top 20. Peru hasn't won Miss Universe since 1957, but Camila hopes to change that tonight.
Nonprofit organization to build a water supply point in her village. Just by providing access to clean water, she dramatically reduced the spread of disease throughout her entire community. That's what you call a queen with a cause, and she is strutting it and owning the moment right now. Colombia!
When she was a teenager, Colombia was ranked among the top 10 athletes in the Colombian Tennis Federation. That competitive spirit, combined with more than a decade of modeling experience, could give her an edge on stage tonight.
Pakistan is making history tonight as the first semifinalist to wear a burkini on the Miss Universe stage. She chose this style as a nod to her Pakistani culture in hopes of proving that you can be modest and still be Miss Universe.
Australia!
Australia's friends and family are hosting watch parties in Melbourne, Perth, and Sydney. Now later tonight, one lucky lady will walk away with the Spirit of Carnival Award and a Carnival Cruise for two. Stay tuned for that announcement.
Miss Universe airs. Her mom and cousin both won international pageants, and Michelle hopes to continue that family tradition here tonight. Portugal!
When Portugal won her national title, the only thought running through her head was, Miss Universe is in 3 weeks! She says preparing for her time in El Salvador was super stressful, but she arrived feeling confident and ready to take on the universe.
South Africa!
Woo, South Africa jokes that her hair has a personality of its own. She took 10 private lessons with stylists to learn how to keep her hair under control here in El Salvador. And I gotta say, she has nailed it. She is looking flawless on that runway.
Thank you.
El Salvador!
El Salvador is related to 5 pageant title holders, and one of those relatives made the top 10 at Miss Universe 13 years ago representing Guatemala. I can't wait to see if Isabella can meet or exceed that accomplishment tonight.
Swimwear. Now let's hear from the
know what you thought.
Y'all, we are still having a party up here.
Yes,
okay?
We are.
The delegates look like they were ready to hit El Salvador Surf City beaches in their swimwear. I loved the confidence and the fun that all of the ladies were having.
Oh, my goodness. The attitude, the personality, the cleanness of the execution of the pasarela.
Yes.
All you fashion fans know what I mean.
You better roll that R, girl.
Oh, yes. And if you were seeing some of those swimsuits up there saying, hey, I want to add that to my collection, well, you guys have good news. You at home can get the same swimsuits worn during the competition, the custom Miss Universe by Ruben Singer swimwear line called Off the Runway. So you see a QR code, just scan that on the screen to reorder any of the designs or all of them.
Yes.
I mean, no judgment here. Or head to the MU online store or app.
Put them in the cart. Thank us later.
Yes.
This is the 72nd Miss Universe, and we are live on the Roku channel. Stick around, y'all. Can we go back to dancing now?
You can. Not just on Roku devices. So whether you're looking to reach a big audience or a small one, you can start your TV streaming campaign today with Roku Ads Manager.
With changing these homes, we can change families.
Cooks.
This is the movie that we're gonna make. We're improvising the action scenes. Nice to beef you.
They're literally trying to murder us.
Only one man can help you.
Go.
It's Kevin Hart.
Well, how do you like your tea?
This competition is about understanding the fundamentals and traditions in sushi and Japanese cuisine.
I'm ready.
Yeah. This could be anyone's game.
Now you can binge your favorite Martha Stewart lifestyle shows free on the Roku channel. Learn classic cooking techniques and live your very best life. What can I say? I'm a bit of a multitasker.
We call ourselves Cowboy Skywatchers. What we're looking into is extraterrestrial activity.
What was that? What was that? We're seeing two white lights.
Segment. Now, guys, I am so excited to introduce you to my beautiful guest next to me right now, a vital part of the Miss Universe team. Of course, Hillary Cruz.
Hi.
Welcome. Hi. Thanks for coming up to the booth. You're also a consulting producer on the show, and you have such a fascinating resume. Can you let us in? Like, how did you find your way here in this kind of work?
Well, thank you so much. Yeah, I'm thrilled to be here as a producer for Invent TV, and it is so special to me because in 2007, I was with Teen USA.
Right.
And so it's my world's colliding, and it's just such a pleasure.
Which is incredible because it gives you that sense of relatability. You've been on stage, and now you're behind the camera, behind the scenes, and you know just what the candidates are feeling. So what for you would be, would you say, the most crucial part of the competition?
Well, I think the interviews that you know very well, but I think the interviews and the final questions are really important. You know,
definitely.
Title holders in Miss Universe are really ambassadors who use their voice and travel the world, and they, you know, speak on really important issues and causes. So being able to communicate well, I think, is really important.
You couldn't have said it better. And we both know the life-changing aspect of winning a competition just like this. What are your thoughts on that?
Yes, our lives truly did change overnight, and it is such a blessing, and it is an incredible experience, not only just for that year, but to be a part of this amazing sisterhood is something really special and unique. So I'm so excited to see who
you couldn't
is
have
gonna join
said it
us
better.
Tonight.
Hillary, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank
All right, guys, we're moments away from finding out the top 10. Don't go anywhere.
I recently visited beautiful Suchitoto, where they have been using indigo dye in their clothing since the 16th century. I have a deep appreciation for both history and fashion, so I couldn't wait to learn more about the ancient techniques that are still in practice today.
Very strong.
After dyeing some local fabric, I felt inspired to bring it back to my studio in New York and design a dress for my next visit to magical El Salvador.
Welcome back to the 72nd Miss Universe competition. 20 delegates took the stage in the swimwear competition, but just 10 of them will move on to the evening gown round.
And the scores are in.
Ooh, they're right here. It's time to find out which 10 are moving on.
I'm ready. Let's do this already, all right? Here we go. The first woman moving on to the evening gown round is... Let me peek, Olivia. Ooh.
Go.
I heard it right here. Puerto!
The next woman, still in the running, is Peru!
Taking the next step in the competition is...
Two spots left. Up next is
favorites. That's right. We cannot wait to see our top 10 slay in their gowns. Now, a couple of nights ago, all 84 delegates had a chance to use incredible creativity and introduce our worldwide audience to their homes and their cultures, all through the power of fashion.
Zuri, it is one of my favorite parts of the competition. Of course, I'm talking about the national costume show. So let's take a look at some of the highlights of Thursday evening show.
The evening gown competition with a special performance by John Legend.
But when we come back, we'll be announcing a special prize for three of our delegates.
This right here is Miss Universe live on the Roku channel.
Updating your home can make a massive difference.
This is going to be awesome.
And if it's not, go after her.
Oh my God!
With changing these homes, we can change families.
From hot beignets in the French Quarter to ice-cold sake in the wetlands, we're cooking up a new season of delicious Louisiana dishes. Welcome back to Emerald Cooks.
This is the movie that we're gonna make. We're improvising the action scenes. Nice to beef you.
They're literally trying to murder us.
Only one man can help you.
Go.
It's Kevin Hart.
Well, how do you like your tea?
This competition is about understanding the fundamentals and traditions in sushi and Japanese cuisine.
I'm ready.
This could be anyone's game.
For everyone out there, follow your dreams.
Now you can binge your favorite Martha Stewart lifestyle shows free on the Roku channel. Learn classic cooking techniques and live your very best life. What can I say? I'm a bit of a multitasker.
We call ourselves Cowboy Skywatchers. What we're looking into is extraterrestrial activity.
What was that?
What was that?
We're seeing two white lights.
When we were little, we loved playing with Lincoln Logs.
Now we play with these logs. We are the only log home builders with the Lincoln Logs stamp of approval.
Back in business!
We play with big machines, hardcore tools, and we are Lincoln Log Masters.
The Marriage Pact, an agreement between two people that if they're still single by a certain due date, they'll marry each other.
Holy f***.
I suck at relationships. It's the truth.
Welcome back to our Roku bonus segment. We just caught the highlights of the National Costume Show, which went down here on Thursday night.
It was a spectacular show, guys. It's always one of the most fun events that takes place at Miss Universe. You know, all of the imagination, the history, the craftsmanship of the designers of all of a country blending together to create truly unique fashion moments.
Absolutely. Yeah. Every national costume tells a story, and we are so very lucky to have this incredible accessory piece from Miss Mexico's costume, I mean,
I know you guys thought we had a third co-host up here, but...
Yes. Her costume is called Colors of Mexico, Alebrije Guardian, which means guardian angel. And like many of the national costumes, the design incorporates animals that are symbolic to the country.
Right. So if you can see here, you have an owl's face and then deer antlers, which represent wisdom and focus. The amount of details is incredible. I know it looks beautiful on screen, guys, but even better up close, you can see painted.
Absolutely vibrant. The entire ensemble was stunning. She ate, okay? Tell us which costume was your favorite on our Instagram stories at the Roku channel, or you can ask us anything about Miss Universe,
right? Yeah, please do.
I am having the time of my life right now.
Right?
The stress, the competition is stiff. How are you feeling so far?
I mean, I'm anxious, but excited. I feel like a fan, and I'm also remembering when I was up there, so it's a combination of emotions, but I'm so happy
absolutely.
To be here with you.
Absolutely same. Reunited, and it feels so good. Gloves reuniting on these riding songs. I'm stuck. We've got more Roku bonus segments on the way, but right now we're headed back to the stage, okay?
Yeah.
You are streaming Miss Universe on the Roku channel.
Hey, girl.
Introducing the Miss Universe 7C Plus, formulated with a complex of botanicals found in the seven continents of the world: Africa, Southeast Asia, North America, South America, Antarctica, Europe, and Australia. The secret is in you. Miss Universe Skincare. Every moment, beautifully confident.
What kind of change do you feel like you're bringing to Miss Universe?
Well, in my case, for many years, to participate was a dream, and it came this year.
I respect a lot your journey, your values, and it's very brave you will be here.
I was about to say it's about breaking boundaries and going beyond the stereotype that people set for us. You're the first mother and transgender. Whatever it may be, our journey has already made an impact on the people around us.
Somebody like me is on that stage, and I do believe that's very beautiful, and I'm so happy that I'm here with you guys.
That's true. Yeah.
Every year, the Miss Universe delegates show they have a tremendous desire and capacity to make the world a better place through their philanthropy.
This year, in a historic first, the Miss Universe delegates have been called to amplify their voices and ignite global change through a social impact initiative called Voice for Change, presented by MOWAD and CI Talks.
Delegates were given an opportunity to submit video stories addressing social issues and causes close to their hearts. And the other night, they were recognized for their efforts.
Yes, they were.
During the preliminary competition on Wednesday night, the 10 silver finalists in the CI Talks Voice for Change Challenge were revealed. Tonight, for the first time, we are honored to name the gold winners, three extraordinary women who have gone above and beyond to drive positive change in their communities. Puerto Rico. Carla Gil-Fu Acevedo is spearheading the It's Okay to Not Be Okay program and Break the Silence Surrounding Mental Health Challenges. Angola. Ana Coimbra is addressing high infant mortality rates caused by malnutrition. And finally, Philippines. Michelle D. passionately advocates for autism acceptance and empowerment. Congratulations, and thank you for making a difference.
Congratulations to the three Voice for Change gold winners, Philippines, Angola, and Puerto Rico, who will each receive a cash prize of $12,000.
Yes, on Monday, honey. Coming up, our 10 remaining semifinalists will compete in the iconic evening gown competition as John Legend performs. It's Miss Universe live from El Salvador.
Stay close by me and hold tight, sing and shout, dance right around the crowd and hold tight, shut your eyes, girl, you set me up for Zion.
Updating your home can make a massive difference.
This is going to be awesome.
And if it's not,
go after her.
Oh my God!
With changing these homes, we can change families.
From hot beignets and
competition is about understanding the fundamentals and traditions in sushi and Japanese cuisine.
I'm ready.
This could be anyone's game.
For everyone out there, follow your dreams!
Now you can binge your favorite Martha Stewart lifestyle shows free on the Roku channel. Learn classic cooking techniques and live your very best life. What can I say? I'm a bit of a multitasker.
We call ourselves Cowboy Sky Watchers. What we're looking into is extraterrestrial activity.
What was that? What was that? We're seeing two white lights.
When we were little, we loved playing with Lincoln Logs.
Now we play with these logs. We are the only log home builders with the Lincoln Logs stamp of approval.
Back in business!
We play with big machines, parkour tools, and we are Lincoln Log Masters.
The Marriage Pact, an agreement between two people that if they're still single by a certain due date, they'll marry each other.
Holy f***.
I suck at relationships. It's the truth.
Well, welcome back, guys, to another bonus segment. The holidays are coming up, right?
Yes.
And it is just the most magical time of the year.
Swoon, just when we need her, the queen of the holidays, Martha Stewart, is back on Roku with brand new episodes of Martha Holidays. Take a look.
Cheers, everybody. And happy holidays to all
you
of
too,
you.
Martha.
Welcome to my Roku original Martha Holidays celebrations.
Happy Hanukkah!
Sweet temptations, that is gorgeous. Oh, and festive libations. No one will believe that you made that yourself. Delicious. All good things to ring in the season. Happy holidays, everybody.
Isn't she such an icon?
100%.
I mean, she's got everything you need to make this holiday season unforgettable and for you to be the favorite relative of all your friends
the
and family.
Hostess with the mostest, okay?
Right? Perfect recipes, decorating tips, and gift ideas to boot.
I mean, it's basically comfort television. I feel cozy just watching that, okay? Brand new episodes of Martha Holidays premiere December 4th on the Roku channel.
Well, Zuri, talking about holidays, what is your favorite holiday food?
You know, I love a good mac and cheese. My mama throws down. Yes. Now, what about you?
Please invite me.
Oh, I got you, girl.
I want to come and experience this mind-blowing mac and cheese. I mean, for me, I always love a homemade apple pie.
Do you like to bake?
I mean, I'm not a baker, but I try to make it by scratch every
as long
year.
As you can eat it, that's all that matters. I'm always curious about this. What time does your family sit down for Christmas dinner?
Ooh, it's actually Christmas Eve, and then we have our Christmas Day brunch.
Good to know. Check out Martha Holidays streaming on December 4th. Let's get back to the stage.
Miss Universe is a reflection of society. We have really sought to give everyone a voice. We have sought to be inclusive. Lifting others up and bringing the next generation of women along with you is the most important thing that Miss Universe can stand for.
Era hora de ver a otro tipo de mujeres compitiendo, pero no solamente por belleza, sino que el mensaje que tienen que darle a la sociedad.
I'm not the only trans woman this year. We have another one from Portugal. We have a curvy woman. We have two mothers.
The pageant has turned into a leadership platform. Who has an advocacy who can create a true change?
Miss Universo aprueba y nos da esa voz para todas las mujeres y madres en el mundo de mostrar lo capaces que somos por nuestros propósitos.
Starting next year, we have eliminated the age requirement. We'll continue to be more inclusive, and we will truly be a brand for everyone.
Welcome back to the 72nd Miss Universe competition, where we are ready for one of the biggest and definitely most elegant moments of the night.
Our delegates are going to show off their poise and confidence in an evening gown tailor-made to blow the selection committee away.
Personally, my favorite part of the night, this is the evening gown competition.
Seems so eager, but I want you, baby. From your head to your toes, to your clothes, wanna give me everything you need. I'll bring you, baby. Ain't no party come to tell ya. One look, you got me screaming, ooh, ooh. I gotta get a prettiest damsel here tonight. Come girl, go slay me. Oh baby, go play me. Just think about it, girl, it's you and me. So do you wanna do this?
And now, please welcome 12-time Grammy winner, John Legend!
When I'm lost, when I'm low, how do you always know? Oh, you're right there to save me at the end of my road. When I'm floating in space, how do you stay in place? When the whole world is caving, oh, you're my saving grace. You make me wonder, woman, how do you do it? Some superpower I don't understand. You make me wonder, woman, how do you do it? You're superhuman and I'm just a man.
And here are your semi-finalists, starting with Puerto Rico.
Now, I love this story. Puerto Rico brought photos of her younger self with her to El Salvador. She says that anytime she's doubting herself, she can look at those pictures and just remember how far she's come and just how strong she really is. And I don't know about you guys, but she is an image of strength right now.
Who has been following Antonia's evolution and pageant career since she first competed in 2019. Everything from the dress to the jewelry was custom made for her to wear tonight on the Miss Universe stage.
United States and turned $500 and a tiny garage into a successful Peruvian restaurant. Now she hopes to open a restaurant of her own someday and win a Michelin star.
Designer to create this evening gown, which she says was inspired by her hometown.
Nicaragua!
Those colors look familiar. Nicaragua's blue and white evening gown was custom designed just for her. The most important part, she says, are the colors, which are found at both the Nicaraguan and El Salvadorian flags. And there are plenty of fans of both those countries cheering for her right now. Can you hear it? Philippines!
Philippines was first runner-up at her national pageant last year, and says she came to Miss Universe with unfinished business. This dress was inspired by a 106-year-old Filipino tattoo artist who's helped her keep her unique cultural tradition alive.
She succeeds tonight, Isabella will be winning her country its first Miss Universe crown, not too far from her very own front door.
to do with why Deanna dreamed of winning Miss Universe in a white gown for as long as she can remember. Gown was created by a well-known Australian couture designer, and Australia told us her favorite part of the dress are the emerald green jewels because they bring out the color of her eyes. Beautiful. Spain always carries a photo of her father, who sadly passed away. They didn't meet until she was 9, but they became practically inseparable. She calls him her best friend and knows he'd be so proud to see her in the top 10 tonight.
Hey, you're the best at my worst, more than what I deserve. Always right there beside me, who to put yourself first. Give me hope, give me help. I'm going through hell. Show me loving somebody. Start loving myself. You make me wonder, woman, how do you do it? So superpower. I don't understand. You make me wonder, woman.
Time for John Legend in that falsetto. Yes. First of all, while these Wonder Women work the stage, I was absolutely blown away by their elegance, their poise under pressure.
Wow.
What was it like for you when it came to deciding on a gown?
Stunning. I mean, can I just say, those gowns, the way that they carry them, gorgeous. Beautiful. Wow, what an amazing badge. But when I came to choosing my gown red, actually, my mom had a dream when I was a kid that I had competed in Miss Universe with a red gown. So I was like, my mom must be onto something. And I
love
my designer
Mama
red.
Better manifest, okay? When we come back, we'll find out which 5 delegates are still in the competition for the crown.
Wow, yes, guys, don't go anywhere. This is the 72nd Miss Universe competition live on the Roku channel.
Updating your home can make a massive difference.
This is going to be awesome. And if it's not, go after her.
Oh my God!
With changing these homes, we can change families.
From hot beignets in the French Quarter to ice-cold sake in the wetlands, we're cooking up a new season of delicious Louisiana dishes. Welcome back to Emerald Cooks.
This is the movie that we're gonna make.
We're improvising the action scenes.
Nice to beef you.
They're literally trying to murder us.
Only one man can help you.
Go.
It's Kevin Hart.
Well, how do you like your tea?
This competition is about understanding the fundamentals and traditions in sushi and Japanese cuisine.
I'm ready.
This could be anyone's game.
For everyone out there, follow your dream.
Now
You can binge your favorite Martha Stewart lifestyle shows free on the Roku channel. Learn classic cooking techniques and live your very best life. What can I say? I'm a bit of a multitasker.
We call ourselves Cowboy Sky Watchers. What we're looking into is extraterrestrial activity.
What was that? What was that?
We're seeing two white lights.
When we were little, we loved playing with Lincoln Logs.
Now we play with these logs. We are the only log home builders with the Lincoln Logs stamp of approval.
Back in business!
We play with big machines, hardcore tools, and we are Lincoln Log Masters.
The Marriage Pact, an agreement between two people that if they're still single by a certain due date, they'll marry each other.
Holy
I suck at relationships. It's the truth.
All right, y'all, it is time for another Roku Channel bonus segment. I have got a very special guest joining me now. This is Julio Imede. He is the production designer for Miss Universe. Julio, hello, welcome.
Hi, nice to see you, nice to have you.
Yes, it's so exciting. Now, you are responsible for creating this gorgeous set behind us. I'm so glad you could stop by. First of all, from what I understand, you've got some roots here in El Salvador. Tell us about that and what it means to be back.
I do. I was born in El Salvador. I grew up in Australia. And as a little kid, I used to, you know, growing up here, I used to watch Miss Universe.
Really?
And so I always remember this spectacle, and I was inspired by how wonderful the show was.
Yeah.
So it's an honor to be back here doing such a global show.
I love to hear that. Now, can I just say, my jaw is still on the floor processing this dual runway. Can you tell me more details on this set and what makes it unique?
Sure. The inspiration for this set became about the wonderful landscape of El Salvador. El Salvador is known for the land of volcanoes.
Yes.
So that inspired us to create an architecture about nature, volcanoes, cascades, and waves. So there's two runways behind us that are supposed to represent waves of the ocean and the energy of El Salvador.
Yes. Now, it's one thing to have something in your mind, another thing to make it a reality. So what went into actually creating this and getting the set to El Salvador?
Well, a lot of people behind this. I'm very proud of the collaboration between El Salvador, my studio, myself and my team, and Miss Universe. But it took a lot of people, a few trips down here,
yes.
And wonderful to be here.
Gorgeous. Thank you, Julio. And speaking of incredible work on this stage, let's get back to it.
For the past 4 years, we have partnered with the Miss Universe organization to present the Spirit of Carnival Award. This year, I am so very pleased to recognize Michelle D, representing the Philippines. We look forward to seeing you on a Carnival cruise ship in 2024 when you sail with us. All of us at Carnival are very proud of you.
Delegates have just completed the evening gown round, and now it's time to find out who will move on to our top five. That means, sadly, five more of these accomplished women will be heading home, and the first one is on this list in my hands. The first delegate advancing to the top five is Australia! Joining her is Puerto Rico. Oh, them to the top five. Thailand! We are down to the last spot, Maria.
Every one of these women have made their countries proud, but only one will move on, and the last woman advancing is Colombia!
Hero Marisol Malure,
and the man who hosted the most Miss Universe shows in history, Bob Barker. Bob hosted the show for two decades, including right here in El Salvador in 1975. His interviews with the delegates made for some of the most memorable moments in the show's history. They were both beloved by the fans and so many people in the Miss Universe organization. They will be missed.
Updating your home can make a massive difference.
This is going to be awesome.
And if it's not,
go after her.
Oh my God!
With changing these homes, we can change families.
From hot beignets in the French Quarter to ice-cold sake in the wetlands, we're cooking up a new season of delicious Louisiana dishes. Welcome back to Emerald Cooks.
This is the movie that we're gonna make.
We're improvising the action scenes.
Nice to beef you.
They're literally trying to murder us.
Only one man can help you.
Go.
It's Kevin Hart.
Well, how do you like your tea?
This competition is about understanding the fundamentals and traditions in sushi and Japanese cuisine.
I'm ready.
Yes! This could be anyone's game.
For everyone out there, follow your dreams.
Now you can binge your favorite Martha Stewart lifestyle shows free on the Roku channel. Learn classic cooking techniques and live your very best life. What can I say? I'm a bit of a multitasker.
We call ourselves Cowboy Skywatchers. What we're looking into is extraterrestrial activity.
What was that? What was that?
We're seeing two white lights.
When we were little, we loved playing with Lincoln Logs.
Now we play with these logs. We are the only log home builders with the Lincoln Logs stamp of approval.
Back in business!
We play with big machines, parkour tools, and we are Lincoln Log Masters.
The Marriage Pact, an agreement between two people that if they're still single by a certain due date, they'll marry each other.
Holy f***.
I suck at relationships. It's the
truth.
Oh, hi. Welcome back to our bonus segment. Right now, we've got a look at a new Roku original. It's a romantic comedy called How to Fall in Love by the Holidays.
Ooh, you had me at holiday rom-com, but this also stars Terry Hatcher, who I adore. So this next one is extra special. Let's check it out.
I'm not writing a dating column.
You don't have a choice.
You are going to capture Nora's journey to love by showing the magic of the season.
All you have to do is spill your hot cocoa on someone and boom, you got a meet cute.
Meet cute that you just tried to stage for yourself? Never actually seen it in real life.
What are you really feeling, Nora Winters?
That's the best part about love. It can surprise you if you stay open to it.
I mean, how cute is Terry Hatcher in that? And she was so good on Desperate Housewives.
Iconic. Yes. Really iconic. And that movie looks so much fun. I can't wait to check that out.
Yes, I love a good meet cute, you know, especially when it happens over the holidays. Mm-hmm. Now, Kat, you just got engaged. Congratulations, my girl.
Thank you.
Now, did you two have a meet cute moment?
Not necessarily, but we did meet in church. So.
Look at God. I love
that. Thank you, God.
Well, look, I'm still single and mingling, so send all the eligible bachelors my way.
Yes, exactly.
I love that. That could be a movie. Just say it. Now, holiday movies are just so fun to watch and then rewatch. Why do you think that is?
I mean, it makes you feel good, right? We love seeing stories of families coming together or finding everything after all the odds are against you. It makes you feel joyous, hopeful, puts you in the right frame of mind to start up the new year.
Absolutely, it does. You got to kick off that new year right. But How to Fall in Love by the Holidays is already available to stream for free on Roku. Let's get back to the main stage for more of the top five. You're streaming Miss Universe live from El Salvador.
With 84 women vying for the crown, and now we're down to just five.
They've been doing everything they can to impress our selection committee. Now they'll be taking questions directly from the panels themselves, and only three of them will move on to the next round.
If it sounds like a job interview, that's because it is. The Miss Universe winner will be representing the organization for an entire year, traveling the world as an ambassador and using the platform to advance the greater good. So this is their shot to prove they can do it.
The delegates only have one chance to answer, and they haven't been given the questions in advance. Each delegate will randomly draw the name of a selection committee member, and they in turn will ask one question. The delegate will have 30 seconds to answer. If their time is up, we will hear a sound like this.
And of course, we will provide interpreters for the delegates who requested them. Let's get this party started.
Australia, you are up first. Please come on over and choose a name.
Hi.
You have chosen number 9, Iris Mittener. Iris, what is your question for Australia?
Hi, Miss Australia. So, how will you use the Miss Universe platform to promote global gender equality?
I would use the Miss Universe platform to push a message. I think this community is strong, and when we bond together, we can create changes. And when it comes to gender equality, when we use our voice and we use our power to make a change, that's when real movement happens. Gracias, El Salvador.
Thank you.
Okay. Puerto Rico, it's your turn. Come on over and select a name. Thank you. You have selected. Number 4, Janelle Comisión.
Hello, Miss Puerto Rico. If you win tonight, what would you bring to the Miss Universe brand?
Si llegaras a ganar esta noche, ¿qué aportarías a la marca de Miss Universo?
I would use that opportunity to show the world the relevance of beauty queens nowadays. I would use my activism on regarding mental health and telling the world how it is important that if we use our voice, if we take up space, if we are courageous enough to be ourselves in this world, I would use the platform to reach and be that. Thank you so much.
Thank you. We're going strong here. All right, Nicaragua, it's your time to come on down. Please choose the name of a committee member. All right, you chose number 1, Halima Aydin.
What qualities and values guide you as a leader and role model for others?
¿Qué cualidades y valores y
guían para ser un buen ejemplo a seguir para los demás.
La cualidad que me ha inspirado y he llevado a inspirar a muchas mujeres y niñas el día de hoy.
The quality that has inspired me and has inspired millions of women and girls, I apologize, today.
Es la humildad y aprender a agradecer las pequeñas cosas.
It's humility and to be able to appreciate all of the little things.
Porque es ahí donde está lo más valioso. Es la esencia del ser humano.
Because that's where the most valuable thing is, the essence of being human.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thailand, you are up. Thailand.